I don't think there's anything that can analyze a file and spit out a reverb. This has got to be the first one, right? Yeah, so that's a game changer. So this is going to analyze that location audio and say, here's the reverb that was present in that room. That is Dialog Match. And what does it have? It has an EQ module, it has a reverb module, and it has an ambience or room tone module. Those are the three main ingredients for matching Dialog. So let's just play the location audio.
We would simply cease to draw breath if we limped the lane with conscience to our graves without pursuing on all accounts.
Listen to the quality of it, right? So we're all ADR engineers now. And we're listening, we're saying, is it muffled? Is it crisp? Is there a lot of room in it, right? We're trying to make these decisions as we listen to it, because now after we listen to this a couple of times, then we got to go to the replace Dialog and figure how we're going to match it, right? So let's play it again.
We would simply cease to draw breath if we limped the lane with conscience to our graves without pursuing on all accounts.
Okay. They've given me two replacements. They've given me a boom replacement and a lob replacement. So let's listen to the boom.
We would simply cease to draw breath if we limped lane with conscience to our graves without pursuing on all accounts.
And here is the lob.
We would simply cease to draw breath if we limped lane with conscience to our graves without pursuing on all accounts.
So I'm going to tell you right now that I'm going to choose the boom as my replacement because I feel like it has some of the bottom end that I want. It's not crisp. It doesn't have the crispness of the original, but it does have some of the qualities that I like in the original. So how does this all work? Here's my location. I'm going to capture that as my reference. Now, if you look, do you see that purple bit up there? Remember I was talking about that EQ curve, right? I'm gonna run my audio through a frequency analyzer. Well, that's what I'm gonna end up with. So that tells me, if you were reading that as an engineer, down at the bottom is 0 or 10 or 80, and up at the top is 15,000 or 20,000 cycles per second. So that's telling you right there what that EQ is that is embedded in that file. So now I'm going to go down to the boom, and I'm going to capture that. And that's the EQ curve of the boom. Now, I know if you're not an engineer or whatever, they kind of look the same. Those are completely different EQ curves. You can see that there's a little scoop there, but a higher bottom end on the replaced audio than on the reference audio. They both have the same sort of gentle slope going down, but there's a weird little cut right here in the Dialog that's not in the ref. So this is what I was talking about. I'd be looking at these things, and then I would sit with an EQ, and I would try and dial up a bump right there so I can match. Well, I don't have to do that. They just did that for me. They have just matched this EQ for me. So that's the first part. The second part is the reverb, right? The quality of the room, and the third part is the room tone of it. So now I can hit the preview button here in Audio Suite.
We would simply cease to draw breath if we limped lane with conscience to our graves without pursuing.
So that's applying these specifications from the location audio to the boom mic.
We would simply cease to draw breath if we.
Now, I want you to look up here in the purple area. When I hit the preview button, you'll see a little ear up there. And what that is that will allow me to listen back to the original audio. So let's do that.
We would simply cease to draw breath if we limped lane. We would simply cease to draw breath if we limped lane with conscience to our. We would simply cease to draw breath if we limped lane with. We would simply cease to draw breath if we limped lane with conscience to our graves without pursuing.
Now, again, we're not in a perfect situation, but that's a pretty clear match right there. So I'm going to burn now. I'm going to hit render. And so now I have the Dialog replacement.
We would simply cease to draw breath if we limped lane with conscience to our graves without pursuing on all accounts.
Now, for somebody who doesn't do ADR and somebody doesn't know why this is important, let's say you do 10 takes for every line that's going to be replaced. This is the way I do it with them. So let's say we do our 10 takes, and I sit there with the director, and the director goes, oh, I love that one. That was a great reading. But I look at it, and I can see the lips are not even close. So I have to say to the director, actually, that's not going to be a good take. because I know from experience I'm not going to be able to cut that to sync. So we go, okay, so we go down the line, and I usually force them to pick three. I say, what is your absolute favorite Dialog replace? So, and then I put them in order, 1, 2, and 3. Best on top, A, B, and C. And then I do that through the whole thing. So we do all of our recordings, and then I sort them all out, so I know that at least that day, the director loved that take. This is what happens, though. So now we've recorded all the replacement dialogue, the actors have gone home, the director has made his circle takes. And then he says to me, you know, there's really not a problem in those first three words in the location audio. And I love the way she says that. So let's take the first three words from the location audio, and then we'll use the ADR for the rest of that sentence, and then we'll go back to location again. That's why you need dialogue match, because when you just play that new little run of replace dialogue with location audio, it can be a nightmare because they just don't match. And so that's when you sit there with an EQ and a reverb and you're trying desperately to do all these little band-aid things. This is really going to be a game changer when it comes to that, because we are so close already. Now, I'm not saying you're just gonna go through, you're gonna click a button a couple of times and you're done. That's not the way it works in anything that we do, whether it's picture or sound, but this is gonna get you so close. And like I said, there is nothing that I can think of that can analyze a file and give you a reverb print of that file. That is absolutely a game changer. And when I get to the a couple down here, you'll see what I mean by that. So I also wanted to talk about Ambience Match, because that is built into this, and I want to explain to you why that's important. So I want to play this little bite here. You can see it there in the waveform if you look at it. That's noise, right?
Tony, look up at her, and line.
Devil must be whispering sweet words.
Okay, so let's just say on this day of recording, the location recordist did not record room tone for me. And now I've got this director blabbing through the scene. Well, I can't just cut to silence, right? I have to have that room tone to paste that in over the director going, hit your mark over there, now open the door, right? This happens all the time, right? Say your line! And then the actor says their line, and now you're stuck with a bite that has all this blabber. And, you know, if it's in a controlled environment, if it's on a set and it's quiet, you can get away with that. But you can hear this, it's like distant traffic. Let's listen.
Tony, look up at her, and line.
Now that is a very distinctive thing. And that's why when engineers say to producers or picture people out there, why do we need room tone? You know, in my book, my first chapter of my book is room tone. Because room tone is key. Room tone is the glue for everything that we do. What I can do here is I can come down to my ADR final track. And now, there's nobody talking. There's no footsteps. There's nothing. I have room tone. So now I can just make a little copy of this. Let me bring it down here. No more director.
Devil must be whispering sweet words.
It's pretty impressive, isn't it? Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. I'll be here all night. This is a really idiosyncratic recording. When I play it for you, you'll know what I mean. And I would know right off the bat, I'm gonna have a hard time matching this. And it's really, again, it goes back to what I was saying before about reverbs, because of the room sound, the reverberant quality of the room is very difficult to duplicate. But so here it is.
Up
Now, I know this director well enough to know he's going to say to me, I want the first three lines from location, then I want, you know, and it's like, wow, man, that's a tough one with this. So let's play the ADR that was recorded for it.
Upon this night, when the veil is thin, we call out to you.
So we're going to do this again the way we did it before. We're going to highlight our location audio. We're going to capture that. Okay, and now look at that curve. So this is the kind of thing that makes you crazy. If you're staring at an EQ curve like that, and then you're staring at a 16-band parametric EQ going, I got a dip there, I got a up, oh, it's crazy. And now I'm going to capture the replacement. Okay, completely different EQ. So it's really a guessing game, right? Don't have to guess anymore. EQ Match just did that for me. It has not only figured out what the EQ of the Dialog should be, but it's also figured out what the reverb of that room should be. So let's listen now to the preview of what it's going to do to that dry replacement audio we heard. It's pretty good. If we hit the advanced tab here, that is the EQ curve that it's read from your reference, that it looks at your what you're going to apply it to, and it knows what those EQs are, and it has intelligently said, that's the curve I think you need to add to match. But if as an engineer, you say, oh, it's close, but let's say you just need it a little crispier, you can just bring up one of those bands if you wanted, or you can bring up the whole shebang if you needed, up or down. It does it, you know, all together. That's very useful. So that's one thing. Another thing I want to mention is, let's say that you think the EQ is right, but there's not enough of it. You can come over here. Now the EQ is always 100% because it's saying, this is the EQ I think you should use at 100% of it. But you can say it's a little much and you can bring it down. You see, if I bring it all the way down, it makes it flat. I have not applied any EQ. If I bring it to 100%, that's what the device has determined is the correct EQ. Or I can go all the way to twice as much to 200%. So it's really useful. So that's one aspect of it that's great. So even though this device has decided what the proper settings are, you still can get in there and tweak it as much as you want as an engineer. Don't tell anybody about it. All right? This has just increased your rate substantially. That's all I got. I don't know, what else can I show you? This thing is amazing. We'll be right back.